So, Katie, let's talk about family.
Okay.
In your family, who is nice?
In my family, I think my mom is really nice. She's always looking out for everyone. She always makes sure everybody is happy. And she's just really nice and kind.
Oh, that's great. Who is a funny person? Who is very funny?
I think in my family, my dad is very funny, but I don't think he knows he's very funny.
Right. Oh, that's interesting. Now, who is serious? Is anybody serious?
I don't think anybody is serious in my family.
No uncles or aunts?
Everyone likes to have a laugh. Everyone likes to have a good time. Everyone's always joking.
Oh, what a nice family. Okay, who is very hardworking?
Well, obviously, my mom is very hardworking. And she's always been very hardworking. She has to make sure that the whole family knows what they're doing. She has to make sure the whole family is ready for every day. Yeah, I think my mom is the hardworking one.
Okay. Is anybody not hardworking? Maybe a little lazy?
Definitely me. Definitely me. Especially when I was younger. I would never help with any of the chores in the house. I was definitely the lazy one.
Oh, I understand. I'm the same way. Okay, now in your family, who is very smart?
My brother is really, really smart. He actually went to Oxford University.
Whoa.
Yeah, he's very smart. But I didn't get any of that. My brother has all the smart genes.
Wow, that's a good school. Okay, who is very fit?
Well, my dad is a chef.
Oh, really?
And yeah, my dad makes really, really good food. So no one in my family is fit. We all eat too much food.
Oh, nobody exercises a lot?
Not really.
Oh, okay. Yeah, in my family, my dad is super fit. Okay, in your family, who is talkative?
Oh, I keep saying my mom for all of these, but my mom is definitely the most talkative. She talks to anybody who, even if people who she doesn't know, she will talk to anybody. Strangers on the street, people she meets at the bus stop, she talks to everybody.
Oh, that's cool. Now, who is quiet?
I think when he's meeting people for the first time, my brother is very quiet. He's very shy. He doesn't like speaking to new people a lot.
Okay, thanks a lot. Sounds like a nice family.
Yeah, I think so too.
Abby Demi, what did you do for summer break?
For summer break, I went to visit some countries in Asia.
Ooh, what countries?
I visited Thailand, Laos, Vietnam, and Myanmar.
Oh, great. What did you do in each country?
In Thailand, I was there for about a week. I ate a lot of delicious food, and I met many nice people. I love Thailand, so I hope to return again.
What foods did you eat?
I don't remember the names, but I just remember that they were all good.
Yeah. Thai food is so good.
Yes.
Did you go anywhere in Thailand, like the beach or the forest?
I was more interested in nature, so I traveled from Bangkok to Chiang Mai and Chiang Rai, and I went trekking and rode elephants, so that was one of the highlights of my trips.
Oh, nice. How long was the trek?
The trek was about a day. It was a trek for 2-3 hours, but then we also stayed overnight in a community in the hills, and then the next day we trekked for a little bit to come back to the city.
Nice. So was Thailand the first stop?
Yes, it was my first stop. It was supposed to be the shortest stop, but I loved it so much that I spent more time there.
After Thailand, where did you go?
From Thailand, I moved on by land to Laos.
And what did you do in Laos?
In Laos, I mainly was in the northern part of the country, and I went zip lining.
Ooh, fun.
It was fun.
So zip lining is going flying from tree to tree.
That's correct. So that was about 2 days worth of zip lining. And we stayed overnight in a big tree house.
Oh, how fun.
It was quite
nice.
I really enjoyed it.
So, after Laos, where did you go?
After Laos, I flew to Vietnam. And actually, I took the bus into Vietnam.
Okay.
Yes. And in Vietnam, I traveled from the north, from Hanoi, to Ho Chi Minh City. But because my time was so short, I could only spend 1 or 2 days in each city.
Wow, what city did you like the most?
I think I prefer Hanoi the most. The food, the street food is amazing. It's a very lively city, lots of motorcycles and traffic. So it reminded me of Nigeria, where I was born, a little bit.
Oh, cool.
Yes.
And what did you do in Vietnam?
I spent time in Hanoi. I also went to visit Sapa, which has a lot of rice terraces. So these are mountains where they've planted rice fields. So the scenery, the view is really beautiful. And you also get to meet the native peoples, the local peoples there. So I enjoyed it. And then from there, I went to Hoi An, which is a very historical city. Very beautiful night scenery by the river. And then I went to Ho Chi Minh City, but I could only spend one night there before leaving for Myanmar.
Okay. And then how was Myanmar? What did you do there?
Myanmar was my last stop, and I didn't have so much time there, but I managed to visit some of the places I really wanted to see, like Yangon, Bagan, and Mandalay. I would say that Bagan was the highlight. They had many temples from the past, and just seeing that many of them, it was very impressive.
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yes.
So, what country was your favorite?
It's hard to say. They each have their own good points, but I think I would definitely like to visit Thailand again.
Oh, okay. Thailand, that's in a great place. Anyway, thanks, Abidemi.
Thank you, Todd.
So, Meg, are you busy this weekend?
Yes, I'm so busy because I'm moving.
Oh, no.
Yeah, there's a lot of work to do.
What do you have to do?
First, I have to prepare my apartment. So I need to pack all of my things.
That's not fun.
No, it takes a long time.
Do you need help?
Yeah. Do you have time to help me?
I can help you on Sunday.
Oh, are you busy on Saturday?
Yeah, on Saturday I have to work. I have to teach two classes. And then after I teach, I have to grade papers.
It sounds like you're really busy too.
Yeah, plus I have to meet my friends that evening.
Oh, what will you do with your friends?
I'm helping my friend also. My friend has car problems, so I have to take him to the mechanic. But on Sunday, I can help you.
Okay, that would be great, because on Sunday, I have to take some trash to the dump, and I have to finish some paperwork at City Hall to prepare for moving to a new country.
Oh, now, because you're moving, do you have to go to the post office?
I do have to go to the post office. I almost forgot. At the post office, I have to submit a form to say my new address.
Ah, that's good, because I have to go to the post office too.
Oh, really?
I have to send my mom's birthday gift to her.
When is your mom's birthday?
It was 1 month ago.
Ah, so you have to send it quickly.
Yes, I have to get on it.
Okay, well, let's go together.
So I'll see you Sunday. What time should I be here?
I have to go to City Hall by 3 p.m., so can you come at 2?
Okay, but if you want to go to the dump closes at noon, so we have to leave earlier.
Okay. Can you come at 11?
Yes. Okay, so I will see you at 11 o'clock.
Great. See you then.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, Katie.
Yeah?
Let's take an international test.
Oh, okay.
How international are you? Let's find out.
Let's find out.
Okay, first, have you ever eaten Greek food?
Greek food? I've eaten, how do you say it, falafel?
Oh, is that Greek?
I think so.
Okay.
I've had that, but apart from that, I've never eaten Greek food.
Okay.
How about you?
Have you? I think I have. Well, I've eaten Greek yogurt. Does that count?
That counts.
That counts?
That counts.
Okay. Okay. Have you ever eaten Vietnamese food?
I see it written down. Is it pho?
Pho, the noodles?
Yeah, I've eaten pho before.
Yeah, I've been to Vietnam, so I've eaten Vietnamese food a lot. And pho, the noodles, is really good.
It's delicious.
I've had that too. Okay, now let's talk about languages.
Oh, okay.
Have you ever studied French?
I have. I've studied French for 5 years.
Ooh, can you still speak French?
Nope, not at all.
Yeah, me too. I once studied French years ago, but I haven't spoken French in so long. I can't remember anything.
I can't remember anything either.
Yeah. Have you ever studied an Asian language?
I've studied Japanese.
Ooh, okay.
I can still speak it a little bit now. And I studied a little bit of Korean, but I don't speak Korean.
Oh, really? Okay. Wow, like, I've studied Thai.
Okay.
Because I lived in Thailand for 5 years. And like you, I've studied Japanese, but my Japanese is terrible.
How about your Thai?
My Thai is okay. It's okay. I can talk a little bit. Okay, so have you ever met a Spanish person?
A Spanish person? Actually, I don't think I have.
Really?
I don't think I have met a Spanish person.
Oh, interesting. I've been to Spain, so I've met a few. And we have a Spanish teacher at my school.
Oh, maybe I have met a Spanish person then. Maybe. Maybe I've met a secret Spanish person.
Okay, have you met a Chinese person?
Oh, yes. I've met lots of Chinese people.
Okay. And have you met a Brazilian person?
I feel like if I say no, then I have. Pro- Probably. I've probably met a Brazilian person.
Yeah, I've met a few people from Brazil, so they're always very nice, very friendly people.
Hey, Todd, are you healthy? Do you eat lots of fruits and vegetables?
I guess I am healthy. I do eat lots of fruits and vegetables, but I also eat junk food, sadly. But I try to eat lots of fruits, especially to stay healthy.
What kind of fruits do you like to eat?
Well, I like all fruits. I love all fruits except pineapple. I hate pineapple. I don't know why. I just don't like pineapple. I don't like the taste. I don't like to chew it. It just feels funny. But I love apples, I love bananas, I love oranges. I usually have an apple every morning for breakfast. It's very easy to eat, and I just love apples because you can take them to school, you can eat them quickly, they're very easy to eat. I also like oranges, and I love orange juice, so sometimes I make fresh orange juice in my kitchen. So oranges are great, but my favorite fruits are bananas and strawberries. I love bananas and strawberries, and I love to eat bananas and strawberries together. So my favorite snack is to cut up some banana and then cut up some strawberry and mix them together and then eat them.
Well, it sounds like you really like a lot of fruits.
Oh, yeah, I do.
What about vegetables? Do you eat vegetables every day?
I do. I try to have a salad every day, and I have a special salad I make, and I call it my chunky, crunchy salad. And it's carrots, cucumbers, and tomatoes, and I cut the carrots and cucumbers into small little squares, and then I cut up the tomatoes, and I mix them together. And the carrots, tomatoes, and cucumbers mixed together, the colors are really pretty. And when you eat the salad, it's very crunchy and it's very chunky because it's all little squares. So I call it my crunchy, chunky salad.
Oh, that sounds delicious. Do you ever share it with someone else?
No, I don't, but I want to because I like it so much and I can't cook. So when I go to somebody's house and I need to bring food, I think, oh, I should bring chunky, crunchy salad.
That's a good idea. Another idea is to cook some vegetables. Do you cook vegetables?
Not too much. I do cook asparagus. Asparagus is probably my favorite vegetable, and it's very easy to cook because asparagus, you just have to cut up into small pieces, and then you can put the asparagus in a bowl with some water in the microwave, and you can cook asparagus in about 30 seconds. So I eat asparagus a lot. Also, I eat broccoli. I love broccoli. Sometimes I have broccoli and lettuce together for my salad. And then sometimes I cook eggplant. I like to cook eggplant because I like the taste and it's easy to cook.
I don't really like eggplant.
Really?
I don't.
Oh, no. Why not?
It has a strange flavor to me. So I prefer not to eat eggplant.
Well, as long as you eat your veggies.
Yes.
So Meg, you look like a healthy person. Do you eat lots of fruits and vegetables?
I do eat lots of fruits and vegetables, especially fruit. I love to eat fruit because it's so sweet.
Yeah? What fruits do you like?
I love bananas because they're so healthy for you. And so usually in the morning for breakfast, I'll have a banana. I also love blueberries. Blueberries are my favorite fruit, but sometimes they're expensive, so I can't often eat blueberries.
Oh, I agree. Blueberries are so good. I love blueberries in oatmeal.
Ah, that's a good idea. I love to have blueberries in muffins.
Oh, that's nice. Well, you bake. Do you bake blueberry muffins?
I do bake blueberry muffins and also blueberry bread, blueberry pancakes, many blueberry things.
Oh, wow. That's great. Mm. So are there any fruits you don't like?
I don't like kiwi, actually, because the flavor is okay, but the fruit is too soft. So usually I don't want to eat kiwi.
Oh, wow. I love kiwi. I love kiwi and bananas. Mm, it's very good.
Sounds okay, but maybe I'll just have the banana.
So what about vegetables? Are you a person who eats lots of salad?
I don't eat a lot of salad, but I do like to eat vegetables with my meals, usually lunch and dinner.
So you cook vegetables?
I cook vegetables or I eat vegetables fresh. For example, usually with my lunch, I'll cut up a cucumber and put some salt or pepper on the cucumber and eat it with my lunch.
Oh, great. I love vegetable sticks. So I love carrot sticks, cucumber sticks, radish sticks. It's very good.
Do you like to dip vegetable sticks into any dressing?
I do, but it's not healthy, right? But no. Yeah, I love the dressing, like the ranch dressing with carrot sticks or the ranch dressing with cucumber sticks. It's very nice.
Yeah, it's pretty delicious, but you're right. Not so healthy.
No. So what vegetables do you cook?
Sometimes I cook broccoli. I actually like to roast broccoli, which is when you put broccoli into the oven and cook it for a few minutes. So it's really delicious. You can add some salt or seasonings, and it's easy to make. You can cook some meat or rice while the broccoli is in the oven, and then it's ready for your dinner.
Oh, that's great. Yeah, you see some vegetables, like on a kebab, that are roasted. I guess onions are roasted, peppers are roasted. Do you roast other vegetables besides broccoli?
Sometimes tomatoes and sometimes potatoes, although is that a vegetable?
It is, but it's not a very healthy vegetable.
Oh, so maybe I shouldn't eat potatoes.
Oh, I love potatoes, though. So you roast vegetables. Do you cook vegetables any other way? Do you boil vegetables or fry vegetables?
Sometimes I boil vegetables. For example, I like to boil carrots because they're soft and you can add some spices again to have some flavor when you eat carrots with your meal.
Yeah. Actually, I love carrots, but I only like raw carrots.
Oh, really?
And I hate cooked carrots.
Oh, well, I'll try to remember that if you ever come over for dinner.
Yeah, carrot sticks, please.
Okay.
So, Meg, we are talking about animals. Do you like to go to the zoo?
I love to go to the zoo.
Okay, so when you go to the zoo, what animals do you like to watch?
I really like to watch giraffes. Giraffes are so tall, and giraffes look really soft and friendly. So I wish that I could touch a giraffe someday.
Oh, that's so true. There is a zoo near my house in California, and you can walk up some stairs, and then you can feed the giraffes, and their face is the same height as your face, and they look really, really cute. And yeah, giraffes are great.
Oh, giraffes are so cute. Maybe someday I can feed the giraffes.
I like how giraffes look. I love their face, and I also love camels also, because I think camels have a similar face. They look really cool.
I don't think camels are very cute.
Really?
Yeah, they're so hairy. Camels have so much hair that they look ugly.
Oh, really? Oh, I like camels. They always look cool and relaxed.
They do look relaxed, but I like giraffes better than camels.
Well, what about llamas? Llamas are kind of like camels and are kind of like giraffes. They kind of have the same face. Do you like llamas?
I think llamas look cute, but I've heard that llamas aren't very friendly.
Really?
Have you heard about llamas spitting at people before?
No. Actually, I think I heard camels do that, but maybe llamas do it too.
I'm not sure.
Okay, so what about other animals? What other animals do you like at the zoo?
I really like the zebras because zebras are black and white with stripes. So the zebra stripes are really cool. And zebras are similar to horses. So sometimes I think I could ride a zebra if I had one.
Yeah, that would be cool. Zebras do look pretty cool. Are there any other animals?
Well, there's one animal that I'm afraid of, and that's a bear.
Yeah, bears are pretty scary.
Bears are really scary, and they're so big with huge teeth and giant claws, and I feel like a bear would eat me if I met it in person.
Actually, have you seen a bear in the wild?
No, I've never seen a bear in the wild, and I really don't want to.
Oh, wow. In California, sometimes you can see bears in the wild, small black bears. And actually, the black bears are not that dangerous.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, you need to be careful when you see a black bear in the wild, but they almost never attack anybody. So the one animal you must be afraid of, though, is the mountain lion. So there are mountain lions also in California, and they are scary.
So maybe I should avoid mountain lions too.
Yeah. If you walk in the wild and you see a mountain lion, maybe it's too late. You're already in trouble.
Maybe I'll just keep going to the zoo.
So, Sarah, I see you eat soup every day at work. Why are you eating soup every day?
That's because I love to cook soup.
So, you make the soup?
Yes, it's very easy to make.
So, you cook it and then you just bring it to work every day?
Yeah, I just make a lot on Monday and then I bring it to work every day of the week.
Oh, nice. So, how do you make the soup? What's your secret?
Well, I like to cook very easy. So I buy meat that's already cut up, usually chicken, and then some rice, usually brown rice. And then I buy some vegetables. So after I bought the ingredients, I chop them up and I put them all together in water until it boils and add some seasoning.
Okay. So you say the water boils, so as soon as the water boils, that's when you put in all the ingredients?
Yes, that's right.
So you don't put in the ingredients before the water boils?
No. I guess it's just easier for the water to be hot, because then the vegetables and the meat cook a little faster.
So how do you give the soup flavoring?
I usually add salt and pepper, maybe some garlic, and depending on the type of soup, either maybe some soy sauce or lemon juice.
Okay. Do you put in the flavoring after you put in the ingredients or before you put in the ingredients?
Maybe after, but usually right about all at the same time.
Okay.
So I just put everything in at one time.
And then after you cook the soup, do you put the soup in the refrigerator? Do you let it sit outside?
I usually eat some right then. And I also put it in containers for the week, but I let it sit in the containers out on the counter for a while for it to cool.
Okay.
Before I put it in the refrigerator.
All right. And so you don't put it in the refrigerator until it is cool?
Until it's about room temperature.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice. And then how do you heat it up? Do you heat it up in a pot or do you heat it up in the microwave?
In the microwave. It's the easiest.
Yeah. Nice. So you make enough for 5 meals?
Maybe, sometimes. If I think I will get tired of eating it during the week, then maybe I'll just make enough for 3 or 4 meals. But if it's some kind that I think is really delicious, and I know I'll want to eat it every day, then I'll make a lot.
Well, if that happens, when you make the soup, you can make it for 6 or 7 and give me a bowl.
Okay, I'll do that next time.
Oh, great. Thanks.